Create a circle, place it in front or on top of the cube, and go to Orthographic View. Select the circle, hold Shift and select the cube as well. Go to Edit Mode and go to Mesh, Knife Project. Now you can get rid of the circle and extrude the knife cut. Create a cylinder, place it as far inside the cube as you want the hole to go. Select the cylinder, hold Shift and select the cube. Now press Ctrl minus to cut. The cutter object remains visible as a wireframe, so you can still adjust. To confirm, apply the Boolean modifier. Make sure there is a vertex where you want the hole to be. Press Shift-Ctrl-B to bevel and increase the amount of vertices with the middle mouse button. You may need to change the profile, and 0.085 seems to work well. Then you can extrude the hole. If you've already got some edge loops, select some faces, 4 is already enough, and go to LoopTools Circle. Bevel that bad boy and throw some subdivisions on it while you're at it. Select faces on both sides of the model and go to LoopTools Bridge. This will punch a hole right through your model. Create a curve rectangle and create a curve circle. Scale the circle to create a hole. You can press Shift D to duplicate the hole and move it to create many holes really quickly. Then convert the whole thing to mesh if you want. Extrude it if you want, I'm not going to stop you. Create a circle and move it away from the other objects. Turn on snapping and snap to face, project individual elements. In edit mode, select all vertices of the circle, press G to snap them to the surface. Now turn off snapping. Then in object mode, join both objects with Ctrl J. Reposition the circle if needed, remove the faces underneath, and then fill the faces where needed. Then extrude. Create a second object to cut with, and join both objects with Ctrl J. Select the faces of the object that you want to cut out of by selecting one face and pressing L. Now go to the face menu and choose Intersect Boolean. Then choose the correct options from the menu to get what you want. Enable the Carver add-on in Preferences and go to Orthographic View. Press Shift-Ctrl-X to activate the Carver tool. Press Spacebar a couple of times until you get the circle cut type. Draw the circle and hold Alt to move it to where you want it. Then let go of Alt and left click to confirm the cut. Box Cutter is a commercial add-on, so to use this you'll need to buy it first. Activate Box Cutter by pressing Alt-W. Press D for the pie menu and choose Circle to cut with a circle shape. Now left click on a selected object and drag to change the size of the circle. Let go of the left mouse button to confirm, then move the mouse to extrude the circle. Left click again to confirm. Once you start making holes with Box Cutter, it's difficult to stop.